The Antonio Champalimaud Vision Award, the world's largest award in vision research, will be presented in Portugal on September 10th to Dr. George King and Dr. Lloyd Paul Aiello. The two Joslin researchers are among seven scientists being honored for their work on anti-VEGF eye treatments, which have had a major impact on the treatment of diabetic eye disease.
All of us, and myself particularly, are just thrilled to be recognized with this award. And to be recognized as a part of that with all the other award winners, all of which contributed so greatly to this really unique story that's been evolving over the last couple of decades, is a tremendous source of pride and inspiration for me.
The development of anti-VEGF treatments for eye disease was a nearly 20-year-long journey started by Dr. King and Dr. Aiello after reading reports of a newly identified molecule called VEGF that caused blood vessel growth and leakage.
Treatment for diabetic retinopathy really started in the 1960s and 70s. At that time, over 40% of diabetic patients actually would become blind after 20 or 30 years. The first breakthrough came with the laser treatment that really decreased the legal blindness in a diabetic patient. However, the laser treatment is a destructive procedure. It actually decreased the ability of diabetic patient to see well in low light, such as dusk or dawn. It actually cuts down peripheral vision, so it's actually difficult to go up and down the stairs.
In the early 90s, Napoleon Ferrara, then at Genentech Corporation, reported that he purified a factor called VEGF, or vascular endothelial growth factor, which played a big role in new blood vessel formation and leakage.
I saw that report, and I looked at it and said, that's exactly what we need in the eye to mediate the problems from diabetes.
So the whole point is, if you could decrease the leakage of the blood vessel, then the swelling of the back of the eye will go down, then your vision actually will come back. So that's what VEGF looks like, is causing the leakage in at least 50% of the diabetic patient with this disease.
As soon as we had a good idea that this factor, VEGF, caused these problems going on in the eye, the obvious next step was to try to find something that could block this factor.
After a series of experiments moving from culture dishes to animal models to human clinical trials, it was shown that blocking the actions of VEGF improved outcomes for people with three of the leading causes of blindness in multiple age groups.
And indeed, now we have FDA-approved anti-VEGF agents for the treatment of macular degeneration, diabetic retinopathy, central retinal vein occlusion, and it's incredibly effective in those. This has been hugely beneficial because so many of these patients will gain vision back, not just stay stable, they'll gain the vision. Very, very few lose any vision, so that's a terrific thing. And half of them over the course now of 3 to 5 years, we have data, don't require any additional laser.
Dr. King and Dr. Aiello plan to use the money granted from the award to further improve treatments for late-stage diabetic eye disease.
If we can come up with treatments that could even prevent the patients from getting there, or can we actually develop therapy that we don't have to have injection into the eye or laser, then that would be the ideal situation.